Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for coming to our spring concert, Pleiades. My name is Andrea Vinay, and I'm the Director of Percussion Studies here at UNF. And we have a really exciting show tonight. We have drums, we have mallets, we have otherworldly, celestial music that should be very enjoyable for everyone. The piece that you just heard, Slap Shift, is a really wonderful piece because it's a great introduction to a conga technique where you're playing all the basic stroke types and there's a good tutorial in the beginning and score notes. And it was actually written by my former teacher at Arizona State University, J.B. Smith. I went there for my undergraduate degree. And I think I remember them premiering this piece at PASIC. And it was whoever has good conga slaps gets to play on this piece. And so I think people had to audition to do the work. So it was really fun putting that together and kind of getting a good introduction into hand drumming. The next piece on the program, Shared Space by Ivan Trevino, is a work that, as you might guess, shares the space. So you'll see almost the entire ensemble playing on one marimba and one vibraphone. Ivan Trevino is a good friend of mine. I've worked with him a lot in the capacity with my duo, Escape 10. We've commissioned works by him. We've played his music and coached his music a lot. He's a really talented composer. His music is very popular. He's also a rock musician and a classical musician and songwriter. And he's also on the percussion faculty at UT Austin. So this is the next piece, Shared Space. Thank you. All right, we have a tiny little set change here before the next piece. Mako, actually, I'll just say there's a QR code on your program here on one of the inside pages. If you like what you see here tonight and the spirit moves you, please feel free to donate to the percussion program. Any amount really helps. These funds go to the Percussion Excellence Fund, and this is used for transformative learning experiences for students. It helps us bring in guest artists who will perform on campus and work one-on-one with students and give master classes. It assists with instruments and gear and maintenance, which, as you can see, we have a lot of stuff that we hit on the stage, and from time to time, we need to, you know, repair heads and to get gear so we can play the music that we are in school to play. So, and we can just use it for any the needs of the department. So any amount really helps if you feel inspired to do that. I just wanted to plug that. The next piece on the program is a new piece that I was really excited to program. It's called Mako. It's named after a Mako is a short-finned shark. And it is written by Susan Powell, who is the percussion director at The Ohio State University. And she wrote this for her ensemble Simpatico, which is a chamber group, chamber percussion group. And I saw them premiere this work at the Percussive Arts Society International Convention. We call that PASIC. It happens every year in November. Me and almost the entire studio went last year. We go every year. I mention that every time we have a concert. But I saw this piece premiered at the convention, and I just fell in love with it. I thought it was so awesome. It wasn't officially published at that point, so I've been trying to get my hands on it for a few years now, and then I did a short residency at University of South Carolina last semester, and Scott Herring, who's the director there, is also in Simpatico, and his students played Mako, and I was like, hey, how can I get that piece? Is it published yet? And so I kind of pestered Susan. She was really sweet. So I was able to get the music, so we actually added it to our program a little late because we didn't actually have music until school had started and we were in session for a few weeks. But it's really energetic. It's really exciting. It's very cool. And we get to use some of our most interesting drums in the collection. We had some Chinese toms here, authentic Chinese toms that we got from China. And then we have a bombo here on the edge, which it's actually an Argentinian bass drum. And myself and Dr. Aaron Bodnar and a small group of students in the Music Mentors Program went to Argentina last summer and did... We spent, I think it was 2 weeks in Argentina, in Arroyito and Cordoba, and we played and worked with the professional band in Cordoba and then the Banda Sinfonica in Arroyito and kind of workshopped with them and did a music mentors kind of activities, and it was really a wonderful, life-changing experience. And they have these lovely, really awesome bombo drums. And so I got this thing. This is my drum. I got it home on a plane. It was quite a feat, but we worked it out, and it's... really exciting to be able to use it on this piece. And Anastasia's playing it, and she was actually also part of that group that went to Argentina. So it's kind of exciting to do that. So this next piece is Mako. use my teacher voice? I can, yeah, I can. The UNF Ensemble is made up of undergraduate and graduate students. We have music performance, music education, music technology, graduate students. And I think the unique and special thing about my role here is that I am an applied professor, meaning I teach private lessons to everybody you've seen on stage tonight. But I also direct a percussion ensemble and teach percussion-related courses. So we see a whole lot of each other, but it's really fun for me to see students grow and mature as people and as musicians in different formats of music making. And so that's really fun part of what I get to do every day here at UNF. And the percussion ensemble is kind of an extension of the philosophies and the curriculum that we're doing. It's a big part of the identity of our percussion studio. And this is actually the largest ensemble I've had since I've been here. This is my seventh year. So that's really fun. It really opens up the possibilities and in programming and everything like that. And you'll see on the second half, we have a larger work with a lot of musicians on stage, and it will be pretty full. The next piece on the program, Ignis, is also a brand new marimba quartet. It's a really lovely piece, recently kind of discovered, and so we've been really having fun playing it. I have three sophomores and one freshman who's performing on it. And Ignis means to ignite, so you can as a spark, so you can hear like motives traded around the ensemble, kind of sparking responses from each of the players. So we've had a really good time putting that together, some contemporary music. And after Ignis, we will have a brief intermission because we have a big set change, but it shouldn't take too long. The second half of the program is really exciting. We're doing two really big works, Poe by Ioannis Xenakis and Cloudfolk by John Sathis. So I encourage you to please stick around for the second half after we ignite with Ignis. Hi. I told you, we have a lot of stuff on the stage, but we're making it work here. So the next piece on the program is called Poe, and it is the second movement of a four-movement work called Pleiades by Ioannis Xenakis. And it is one of my all-time favorite percussion ensemble pieces, and I've been, like, dying to do it ever since I started here at UNF. I got to play it when I was in college, and I'd seen it a bunch of times, and it's just, it's like rock and roll math rock drums. Everybody loves the drums, and it's really, really awesome. So I'm excited to do it, and, you know, it's really difficult. It's very complicated, complex, sophisticated music, and so, you know, this was the right year to kind of finally program this piece, so that's really exciting. Xenakis is really known for his pieces because they're just so rhythmically intricate and complex, but they're also so musical. And so what you'll hear is a lot of juxtaposed rhythms and polyrhythms where there's a certain amount of time that is divided into different durations happening simultaneously. There is a lot of that. But then there's also really sharp unisons where everybody is playing the same thing. And that's why I really love this piece, because you have these layers washing over you of just chaotic drums, it seems like, but everything is meticulously mapped out, and, you know, it's like a 5-6 over 4-4, you know, and the score is kind of crazy, actually, and it's about as big as this vibraphone right here, so we had to get creative in making it work on an iPad, because it's really crazy, but it's really a piece of art, because he was an architect, and so it's just so much detail in the piece. And the concert is named after Pleiades, which is the entire work, and the Pleiades are also known as the Seven Sisters, which is a pattern of stars in the constellation Taurus. And what is interesting about the Seven Sisters or Pleiades is that they're referenced, like, all throughout, like, ancient history, because they were integral in helping ancient cultures design their calendars. And they use those stars as their framework for that. So I thought that was really interesting. And the Pleiades are mentioned in the Bible 3 times. So that's your fun fact for the evening. Here's Poe. we are just about ready for the final piece, the final journey here. I will talk about the last piece briefly before my last little tidbit. So Cloud Folk is a pretty new work. It's an immense work for percussion ensemble, nine people on the stage with piano. And you can see Isabella, our percussionist and pianist in-house. She's doing an awesome job. John Sothis is a New Zealand composer. He's award-winning. You have extensive program notes where you can read about all the pieces. But he is really bursting out onto the scene. He's actually a pianist, and he writes for all kinds of instruments. But his music is really energetic and rhythmically, it's just groovy. But it's got some teeth to it, and it's really fun to work on. It kind of strums the heartstrings of a percussionist because we love a challenge, and we love groovy things that are that really make us, you know, work for it. And so this piece is just, it's just a huge work. It's really difficult, and it's kind of nonstop, and there's a lot of really wonderful sounds happening. And it's been played at the Percussive Arts Society, was premiered there actually by Eastman School of Music a few years ago. I remember the first, I saw this piece premiered as well. And so that's been kind of on the list to do as well. And they've done a really great job, you know, putting it together. I want to read some notes from the composer, which you have in your programs, but I'll read it here since it's dark out there. Sothis says, "The Cloud Folk are imaginary visitors to Earth, invisibly parked in our upper atmosphere, observing 21st century human behavior. I'd imagined an arrival driven by optimism, intense curiosity, and excitement, followed quickly by incomprehension, shock, and the hastiest possible departure back into a wondrous universe teeming with life. With no contact made, in fact, avoided at all costs, we were never where we'd been visited." The music loosely follows this narrative. So I think this also fit the Pleiades kind of vibe here on the program. I want to first give a big thank you to the FAC staff doing the lights and the sound. You can see it's a lot of stuff to shuffle up here. So, yeah, I give them a big hand. They're awesome. And a big thanks to my administration and the department and to all the students and the parents out there who support your students being here and working really hard at playing music. Finally, this is kind of bittersweet. I want to recognize our seniors. Total, we have six this year. We recognize Mason Iaconelli and Marvin Belazaire. Do I see Mason in the audience? Is Marvin here? Yay! So they are doing their internship for music education, so their last percussion ensemble concert was in the fall, so we recognize them. And then there are four on the stage now, so total we have six seniors. And this is a really special class of students, and so it's very bittersweet that they'll be graduating. I call them endearingly our pandemic babies because they started their first year of college during the fall of 2020. And I and my whole studio was here in person. And so, you know, we started that journey together. So just imagine that, you know, it's kind of nuts when you think about that. So we've been through a lot, needless to say. And I think it's just a really strong, talented, wonderful group of students that I will miss very much. So I want to ask Devin and Isabella and Ezra to come up here so I can embarrass you just a little bit here. So, 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 Devin Bruner, here on the end here. Devin hails from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and a fun fact is that his teacher was my former student. I taught drama bugle corps, and Dane Romano was in the pit, and then we became good friends, and Dane's a really successful educator in the Oklahoma City area, and so Devin was his student. So he moved from Oklahoma across the country, away from his family, to start at UNF during the pandemic. So he trusted me, and he trusted you enough to do that, so I really, really appreciate that. Devin is an intensely authentic individual who is an artist. You know, he, like, plays percussion here, but he is a creator. He, like, releases singles. He, like, creates his own music and songs and releases them online. Yeah. He has a lot of other talents, you know, besides just doing Hear What You See. And I think he's really just an authentic, sincere individual, a really good person who is really keen to the people around him. And he, you know, is a man of few words, but when he does speak, it's always just so intelligent and thoughtful. And he's a really wonderful, natural musician. And he's just been such an asset to the program. And he was recently voted chapter president of Iota Phi Theta Fraternity of the Year. And I know he's really been a big leader in that regard, and I know we'll leave here and be a really big leader and impact people in a positive way with however that works out. And he's got so many talents and skills that I think, you know, he's one that's going to synthesize all the things that he could do, and he's going to be awesome. So we will miss you. And I have two Devins, okay? So it's Devin with an E at the end and Devin with the O at the end. So I had two Devins start at the same time. So Devin Pita here hails from South Florida. And Devin came to us. He was a flute player in the marching band at his high school. And then he played marimba in the winter drum line. And he had a friend in the studio, Jacob, who was like, hey, why don't you come audition? And I remember that audition. It was like, okay, you know, there's some talent here, you know, and he was good at percussion, but it's kind of funny because I started as a violinist, so I have like a soft spot for people who were like doing something else in band, and somebody's like, hey, you should come play percussion, because that was me. Devin is refreshingly honest. He is a really consistent, honest person, and he is a monster player. He's the go-to guy. Like, anything you throw at Devin, he can do. And it's been like, yeah, give that part to PETA. He played xylophone in the Blue Devils, you know. And actually, and that's why he was like, I had a crazy xylophone part that I wrote in my percussion concerto, and I was like, you're the guy to do it, you know. It can only be you. You did a great job. It's on a CD, by the way. But Devin is such a hard worker. He's really motivated. He's always ready to go, and he really loves what he does. And I have no doubt that he is going to be a killer percussionist in the future, and, you know, also is a passionate teacher. And I think there was a funny story. Oh, one of the things that I love it about Devin is he always laughs at my jokes too. So that's, yeah, it's good. But I'm going to miss him because it's just, he's, both of them together have been really close as well and have played a lot together. And, you know, I think that's special. We can build those relationships. So I am going to miss you, and I know you're going to do great things. And I'll give everybody a hug. All right, next is Ezra. Ezra transferred to us. He's a music technology major. And Ezra quickly got wrapped into the craziness of percussion ensemble. It's been kind of like an MVP. He learned John Cage's Third Construction in about 2 weeks because somebody had some health issues and were not able to play. And so Ezra just, that piece is hard. I mean, anybody know John Cage's Third Construction? We did it like, was it last year? It was last year, right? Yeah, it's crazy. So he was like, yeah, no problem, you know. And he's a man of few words, and he just kind of keeps himself, but he's the last person to tout any sort of, he's very humble, I guess. And I think when you know Ezra and all the students know him, you know, everybody just loves him and gets along with him and thinks so highly of him. And he would never, you know, ever try to, you know, it's funny. I got a joke from another student, like, make sure he takes your compliments in his lesson the other day. And it's like, yeah, and he's like, he's a talented composer and sound designer and a killer player. And so his senior recital, he's composing all these pieces. And it's like, wow, this is, like, really amazing because we're doing lessons this semester, and it's the first time I'm getting to hear some of this. So I think he's a person of many talents and has been just, like, clutch in our ensemble. And is just never complains and is just always working really hard. I know he's stepped into like music tech ensemble. He's done a really great job there. And so I'm also really excited to see what Ezra does. Look for his website and his compositions online coming up soon. But we really appreciate Ezra, and we're so glad that you ended up at UNF. And finally, Isabella Feld, sorry. Isabella auditioned for us and then decided to go to school in Kentucky for a year, and then we got her back. And I'm so glad that we did. Isabella is, like, always so positive and enthusiastic, especially for her lessons. And will just text me, good morning, I hope you have a good day, I hope you have safe travels to your gig or whatever. And it's just, it's so sweet, and she's so thoughtful, and it's just so, like, just so happy and excited to be here and work with me. And that, you know, it's, the students are the reason why we do this, you know, and when things get kind of stressful and crazy, it's, you know, these people that make it work. And so, you know, it sometimes, you know, it just surprises me because it's like, oh, you're thinking of me right now. And it's just so, so sweet. And so she is an amazing musician and is also a really talented pianist. So you'll see her, you know, playing piano on people's recitals and playing piano on our pieces. And she's really talented. So that's really fun because she loves playing piano too. So I think it's been fun to kind of see her, you know, do both things. And helping, you know, us be able to program really awesome music. But a fun fact about Isabella is that Isabella broke her wrist the first year. Was that the first semester? From an angry trap table incident. So we were doing Bach with one hand lessons for a semester. So she was playing, like, Bach violin music with one hand. Quite successfully, actually. So it's kind of funny. So now both the hands are working really well. So that's really people who are so amazing in a lot of different ways. And I really, truly mean when I say that I will miss all of you, and I really value your time here and what you've done, and we will miss you very much. So thank you.